Last year, the U.S. economy suddenly ground into a halt. This year, things eventually picked up speed and started moving again, but only to get stuck again in the biggest log jam ever recorded in our nation's history. Our supply chains are suffering from extended disruptions, and the severity of this crisis is already apparent to the naked eye. Consumers are witnessing empty shelves in major supermarkets all around the country. Car plants are being shut down due to a shortage of semiconductors. Ports remain extremely congested, and millions of containers are now stuck at cargo ships outside the coast of California that can wait up to a month for a berth to finally be able to dock. The situation is so out of control that things have been similarly chaotic onshore, where hundreds of thousands of containers are being piled up after being unloaded from those massive ships. As one industry insider described, right now the backlog of containers stretches as far as the eye can see. In one very revealing video recently posted on social media, a dock worker showed the gigantic piles of undelivered shipping containers sitting at a key U.S. port, exposing the true extent of the supply chain crisis plaguing our nation. Over the past year, numerous disruptions were recorded. Months ago, a key index of the industry found that shortages caused by supply chain bottlenecks jumped up by over 400% from 2020 levels. A combination of several issues, including steep imbalances between supply and demand, a slowdown in global manufacturing, rising shipping and logistics costs, and severe worker shortages have all contributed to the worsening situation we're seeing today. In the video released on TikTok, the supply chain worker, who said to be in charge of crane operations, used his smartphone to document the staggering amount of shipping containers stacked and awaiting distribution on the quay side. The TikTok video, uploaded on October the 13th, has already over 3.6 million views on the social media site. In the 30-second clip, you can also hear the worker complaining about the status quo. The user, identified as Stanimal18, has 12 other videos documenting the shipping container industry. In one of them, he says that one of the reasons everything is backed up is that our container yards are stuffed to the hilt with containers. He records the process from lifting the containers from the cargo ships to loading them in vehicles that will transport them to warehouses. We need truck drivers to pick up our goods, and truck drivers for us are all robots. This is an automated terminal, pretty much, he says. The clip seems to be filmed from one of the container yards at the ports of Long Beach. In fact, Newsweek discovered that the video coincides with Los Angeles Port Executive Director Gene Soroka's announcement in an online press conference on October 14th, in which he said that the cargo surge we have experienced for more than a year continues. September volume at the Port of Los Angeles landed just shy of 900,000 TEUs, and a TEU is a 20-foot equivalent unit. Now, according to Chris Bowden, Managing Director of Business-to-Business Clean Energy Marketplace Squeaky, the monstrous backlog of containers illustrates just how delicate the supply chains of our world are. In a recent interview, he explained that our world supply chains are finely tuned to meet the highest levels of efficiency possible, which means one or two hiccups can cause nationwide challenges. Rarely do perfect conditions exist in the real world, which means a system with no slack, backup, or spare capacity is likely to flounder under pressure. Similarly, Vinagarita Gopal, founder of consumer analysis company Sales Beat, highlighted that the problem will persist until the mismatch between supply and demand is finally solved. The current supply chain crisis is the perfect storm of changes in consumption combined with logistics and raw material constraints. Demand for certain products, cooking ingredients, cleaning products, breakfast products, etc., has skyrocketed due to people spending more time at home. At the same time, companies did not plan for this surge in demand, as they believed demand would go back to pre-outbreak levels. Most U.S. retailers did not anticipate the enormous growth in consumer demand. That's the executive director of the Port of Houston, Roger Guenther. When everybody was staying home and they were getting stimulus checks, they started buying. Since they weren't going on vacation and going to restaurants and buying services, they started buying furniture and bicycles and home improvement goods, he said. As they try to make up for the lost sales, some of them increase their orders by up to 4 times. However, the panic ordering retailers have been doing have resulted in an even bigger backlog, and congestion is becoming so acute that shippers are transferring ships that arrive in California to other ports, such as the Port of Houston, New Jersey, or Savannah. At this point, all available space in the Port of Houston is occupied by immense towers of multicolored containers that can get stranded for weeks until trucks arrive to haul them to distribution centers. The supply chain infrastructure, hobbled by the pandemic slowdown and a shortage of space and workers, was not prepared for the tsunami of consumer cargo, Guenther argues. What you're seeing at our port and a lot of other ports across the nation is this surge in imports is really putting a strain on the supply chain. It's filling up our terminals, filling up all of our extra space. The container terminals are becoming the warehouse for all these goods. Even though there's plenty of supply, millions of products remain trapped at ports and out of the reach of consumers due to lengthy delivery delays, which are causing shortages at the national and local level. As the holiday season approaches, Americans are already getting increasingly frustrated with the growing number of out-of-stock items as the crisis threatens to ruin Christmas. In October alone, online shoppers received nearly 2 billion out-of-stock messages, 3 times more than during the same period in 2019, according to an Adobe Analytics study released Tuesday. The analysis tracked 1 trillion visits to U.S. retail sites. This year, consumers have started shopping ahead of time as they've been enticed by earlier deals, said Adobe. But as e-commerce demand picks up, shoppers are feeling the impact of ongoing supply chain constraint, the company added in its report. The study covered 18 categories and it found that electronics has the highest out-of-stock levels, followed by jewelry, apparel, home and garden, and pet products. The production of several electrical appliances has been hard hit by the global chip shortage. And since conditions haven't improved in almost 1 year, some big companies such as Apple are facing acute financial losses. In a recent statement, the company revealed that it's still struggling to catch up with the demand, and the collapse in production may cost the tech giant over $6 billion this year. Nintendo has also exposed it will be unable to fulfill the holiday demand for its Switch gaming consoles due to the lack of semiconductors. Millions of businesses worldwide have been on the edge due to the endless supply chain disruptions. Many of them have been unable to take advantage of the historic uptick in demand because of the shipping delays. They've also been challenged by a 10-fold increase in shipping costs, and given that billions of dollars in products are stuck at ports, which means they're losing money by the day, the backup is consequently causing a sharp increase in prices. Last week, several companies in retail, food, furniture, and apparel have warned about catastrophic damages affecting supply chain operations. For instance, one of the warnings delivered by companies on Thursday came from IKEA, the world's largest furniture retailer, which said that product shortages would continue for as long as another year. After months of disruption, the company's current inventory level isn't enough to meet the voracious consumer demand. That's why John Abrahamson Ring, the chief executive of Inter IKEA, the owner of the IKEA brand, disclosed that the company had hired its own trains to transport materials from Asia to Europe to try to avoid further shipping bottlenecks. Ring said, "We actually foresee that the availability and raw materials challenge will continue for the better part, if not the whole of, the financial year to the end of August. This is here for a longer period than we thought at the beginning of the crisis," Ring said. According to Jerry Pacheco, the president and CEO of the Border Industrial Alliance, some of the main issues weighing upon supply chain operations right now are the labor shortage at docks and vaccine mandates. A lot of employees haven't come back. A lot of them don't want a vaccine mandate. In the meantime, the cargo is piling up on the West Coast. It's ironic we have so much demand, so many job opportunities, and it's not getting done. Now, the warehouses are running out of space, particularly in California, he explains. The bottom line to you and I is that we are going to be paying more for our goods. It's inevitable. In logistics, if you can save 3 to 4 cents on a dollar, you're doing very well. But when your cost goes up tenfold, you pass that down the chain, and eventually it hits you and I in the cost of higher price automobiles and the cost of higher consumer goods, Pacheco continued. To make things worse on the other side of the globe, congestion continues to soar. Across several Asian countries, truckers are striking against rising diesel prices, which is further delaying deliveries and threatening to interrupt production in many Asian plants. The latest demonstration took place in Bangladesh, where truck drivers have stopped working since last week and vow to continue until the government reverses its decision to hike diesel prices by 23%, according to the country's truck-covered van and lorry owners and workers coordinating council. Shipping line Hapag-Lloyd AG said in a customer advisory, port operations have been affected and cargo movement between districts is restricted. The same is happening in Thailand, Indonesia, and the Philippines. And manufacturers here in America are already feeling the impact of those delayed shipments, particularly in the building sector. Imported materials like doors and conveyor belts are halting the construction of new logistics properties. Our subcontractors can't hold their bids with prices or delivery dates as they simply don't know when they will get materials, said Fran Inman, senior vice president of Majestic Realty Co., a Southern California-based warehouse owner. It's a giant Rubik cubes of codependency. The undeniable interconnectedness of our supply chains used to be a sign of strength and resilience for the global economy. Right now, as each and every country faces its own struggles, our reliance on this global system threatens to plunge our economy into another recession, one much worse than what happened in 2020. This time, as the economy slumps, the price of everything skyrockets. And experts are warning that the worst is yet to come for the supply chain crisis. So buckle up and get ready for a bumpy ride.